Good morning, great Pierre France. Wonderful people, beautiful people. I welcome you this morning. Of course, it is a glorious day, and of course, the one that Chukwu Kikabiama have made. Today is the 18th day of January 2021, the year of our Lord, the year of Chukwu Kikabiama. Elohim, some call him Adonai, some call him Hashim, and of course, people call him on different kinds of names. And in this heavenly language, we call him Chineke Onye Promihe Nile Oma Mama Siamasi Obarankiti Okubiri Nonuya. My goodness me. Alright, this is how we are welcoming you this morning. It is a glorious morning indeed. As I have said, we are back, of course, to continue where we left off, to continue to propagate this gospel according to the restoration of Biafra. It is Radio Biafra Sadek. Of course, don't get it twisted. And of course, we are the people of the East, coming to you live and direct from Johannesburg. It doesn't matter wherever you are, wherever you are hearing the sound of my voice this morning, it is a warm good morning from me. My name is Mazi Kechukwonoha. I hail from a village, of course they call it Omuowa, the light of the world, Owejahonso. And from there I am reaching humanity this morning across the four corners of the earth. It doesn't matter where you are. You can be in the United States of America. You can be in the United States provinces of Biafra. You can be in Australia. You can be in Japan. Anywhere you are, it does not matter. As long as you are tuned in on this platform, Radio Biafra, the first and the last. This is where we preach the gospel according to the restoration of Biafra. And that is exactly what we are about to do this morning. Therefore, I need to welcome you. And as I am welcoming you, I indulge you, please, please, to begin to welcome others. Do you know why? January, February is our history month here on People of the East. If you are with us on Facebook, you will see the clips we are playing. You will see the video clips we are playing, portraying our history. Because if you don't know your history, trust me, you will not know where you are coming from. Because we need to know our history. Those days has gone when they have hidden our history from us. Today, we are telling our stories. Today we are rewriting history, and this is why here on People of the East, now and then we talk about our history, because we need to educate these children that Chukwu Kikabiama has given to us. We don't want them to go through what we have gone through as adults. We don't want them to no. They must know who they are. And this is why it is important. It is imperative. If you are a parent out there, especially those in diaspora, you see all these children we are bringing into this world. Now and then, we need to teach them the history. We need to tell them who we are. They need to understand that they are not from that contraption. We need to teach them that they are from a holy land called Biafra. This is your responsibility as a parent. The Bible said, teach the child, you know, in the way he shall go, so that when he grow up, he shall not depart from it. This is why you have a job as a parent, to teach your children the history, because we are peculiar people. You know, your children probably might be asking you, Daddy, but why are they killing us? But Daddy, why are they hating on us? So it is your, you know, responsibility to explain to that child, to understand. Tell him you are a wonderful person. You are successful. You are peculiar. They are just envy. They are just hating on you for nothing. They are jealous because of the blessings of Chukwu Kikabiama upon you as a Biafran. Tell them about Biafra. Tell them what God has done with that land they call Biafra. Tell them about the deposition of all manner of natural resources that Elohim has deposited in our land called Biafra, so that they will understand that they are great people, that they are chosen generation, that they are elect of Elohim. This is how we are coming out this morning. My name once again is Mazi K. Chukwanoha. It is Radio Biafra Sadek. People of the East is who we are. And of course, Johannesburg is where we at. Reaching humanity across the four corners of the earth. And of course, we are also heading straight to Biafra land, the land of the rising sun. If you are listening to me this morning, it is the History Month. And I'm going to tell you what will happen in this History Month, because we have a lot of giveaways packed for you. We have quiz, and I want to give you those strong questions. I want to give you those most difficult questions. I want to test your understanding of our history as a people. I want to test your understanding of our history as Biafrans, and that is what it's gonna be. But before we do that, we need to do the needful. We need to pray, and we need to commit, of course, this program to the hands of Chukwuoki Kabiama. And of course, as soon as we have prayed, we will move in earnest. It is Radio Biafra Sadek. Let us pray.
As long as we come on air every evening, the whole world must listen. As long as we preach this very gospel, Chukwuoki Kabiama must be with us. Therefore, without any further hesitation, we must proceed to offer every prayer to Chukwuoki Kabiama, who resided in heaven. Therefore, as we always commence, not from today, but from of old, our Father who art in heaven, Nanyin Kebine Ligwe, Kahagedin Song, that your name may be hallowed by men, that we may bow at the mention of it, that we may offer every glory unto thee, that we may offer you every adoration and adulation, because there is none like thee. You fight our battles for us. Every blessed day you demonstrate through your kindness and your everlasting mercy that you are our Lord, our God, and our Creator. This evening we offer these your children unto thee. All over this very planet that you created, they are listening across the entire 24 time zones on this very planet where they inhabit. They are listening to your gospel this very evening, this gospel of redemption, a gospel of hope, a gospel of restoration, a gospel of renewal, this very gospel of freedom, this very gospel of emancipation, as only you ordained that this very gospel must be preached, that mankind may be set free from the eternal damnation of the creation of the British. My goodness me, I want to remain in the spirit, because we must worship heaven. We answer your name, O Lord of hosts. Everything about us is designed to offer glory unto thee. We have atoned for our sins last year. This very year we have not only atoned for our sins, we have spilled, we have shed blood, they have shed our blood. We have let our sacrifice be made unto thee. Even on the 30th of August, as we are being felled by the bullets of the enemy, by the workers of iniquity and of darkness, we remain very strong today to beckon upon thee, to ask you for your mercy and for your grace, to ensure that your kingdom is restored upon the face of the earth, that you can bring your healing hand to bear upon the life of those of them that you created for one singular purpose, and that purpose alone, which is to worship you in truth and in every honesty. Is there any way that we have erred? Is there any way that our ancestors may have sinned? We confess before a congregation of the whole of humanity to ask you, O Lord of hosts, to have mercy upon us. You must have mercy upon us. We have suffered enough. We have been subjugated enough. We have been tortured enough. We have been imprisoned enough. We did not do these people anything. Our only crime is to answer your name. Our only crime is to be born your children. Our only crime is to excel at everything that we place our hands into. Our only crime is to exhibit your glory and your blessing, which manifestedly is upon our lives every blessed day. That is why they want to kill us. That is why the British want to join those of them who don't know you to destroy your creation and your inheritance. You will not allow shame to befall your name. You will not allow the enemies to triumph over the lives of your children, because you created us to exist, to worship, to honor, and to praise you. That is exactly what we are going to do when this Biafra comes. It will come in truth and in every honesty, because we remain every blessed day Chukwa Biama believe whiter than white and whiter than snow. Is there any way that we have sinned that you cannot forgive us our trespasses to enable us to fulfill your own word, which was spoken thousands of years ago, that instead of what you promised not to come to pass, that heaven and earth will cease to exist. You opened your mouth, Shukwakika Biama, to bless mankind to the coming of Yahweh Yeshua, who came here and said, let your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Those words can never be in vain, because they are anchored upon your holiness and your magnificence. That is why in the end we know that Biafra will come, that these children that we have given birth to all over the world, and their children, and their children, and their children, as long as they give birth to them and they are Biafrans, they will worship you in truth and honesty. Through this very work we are doing, mankind will come to understand you. Let your miracle be wrought in our lives. Let us witness and behold your magnificence, your holiness, your mystery, and your grace under our command. O Lord of hosts, we call upon you. We call upon you to heal. We call upon you to provide succor to those of them who are inconsolable. We ask you to come and strengthen those who are weak. We ask you to restore hope where there is hopelessness. We ask you for inclusion where there is destitution. We ask you for one brotherhood, one camaraderie, one bone, one blood, and one flesh of your children. The Ephics and the Bibios, the Ezon, the Shekiri, the Isobos, and also those of them from Isoko. We are traveling all the way to the lands of Igala. We are moving on from there to Idoma, to Igede, to the territories of the Igbo land. All these places we dedicate unto thee. All these lands of yours, we ask you to cover it with your mercy, because Biafra will come, and when it does, we will dance on the streets. I'm telling you, by the time that we are done, humanity will think that we are mad, we are drunk in your glory, and rightfully so, because your kingdom will come to rest upon this very earth. That very kingdom is the unadulterated, non-negotiable sovereignty of the Republic of Biafra, that your will may be fulfilled in our time. All this we pray, all this we ask for, in no other name apart from that name that belongs to you. I had a sosine big baby, run a big baby. He said, my name is Nnamdi Kanu. I am the leader of indigenous people of Biafra all over this very planet, I tell you. I lead indigenous people of Biafra IPOB. So also do I command the armies of Biafra. They are fiercely loyal. They are loyal, I tell you, and doing the work that I expect them to do. I also direct Radio Biafra, not through any power which I possess or any extraordinary knowledge, but by your grace, O Lord. By your grace, Chukwukika Biama. onyam na akpisi ala na efe. We honor you and we adore you. I know that some people listening, including the British, may not understand what we are doing, but there is nobody in Britain that answers Nwachukwu, the child of heaven. We do. Therefore, when we worship our Father, people should not try to be jealous. They should not feign ignorance or misunderstanding, because we are ancient people. We have been doing this for over 5,000 years and will continue to do so until the end of time.
In the make us so every day, long one is very, very jerry, get a biddy, eh, make up in a so. As a cavana, if well, 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 electric railroad will ye, lead you to Pariara, your Kamekar Maswana. If one other you look pena, of Kojuko, of Komuko, but of the Avadi Kuakona, of Koya Wumetiana, Panda, what you look at, it can't look at that, it can't look at that, and I call a woman in one of Ariana. Come make our sweat in the now Kumama, Uruguay back a row. If you when you're not so wacky, you know, it's in the power. If you're not a kid, it's in the
I'm not going to be able to do it.
once again. I welcome you once again in this Radio BF. We are the people of the East, of course. This is actually my first broadcast of the year 2021. I haven't been able to come up on air since this year, so this is my first. So I will take it as this is my first of January broadcast, of course, and I need to do the needful. If you are listening to me wherever you are this morning, I want to welcome you. You know how we do. It is Radio Biafra. It is people of the East, and this platform is where we worship Chukwuoke Kabiama. We do things unorthodoxly. We do things extraordinarily. So you just need to flow with us how we do it. We don't have order of program or how we do it, item 1, item 2 to item 7, but I can promise you one thing, it is your satisfaction galore here on People of the East. Welcome once again, my name is Mazi Kechukwu Onoha. Of course, it is History Month here on People of the East, and this morning, like I said, we are going to give away some prizes. Of course, it might be a little prize, but the most important thing there is the thought. It's not really about the money or whatever it is that we are giving out. So I'm gonna give out a question, and I will expect you to give me the correct answer. If you get it right, of course, you will win that prize. But just listen, this competition is exclusively to people in Biafra land. This competition is exclusively to people from Biafra land. And of course, and this competition as well is being sponsored by one of our brother, one of our own. I know he wouldn't want me to mention his name, but of course I will want to mention his name, because he is our brother Simon Anyogu. He might not like it that I'm calling his name on air, but he is the one who said, listen, I think I want to sponsor this. And of course, we appreciate him. The thought is what counts. So our brother Simon from Spain, he is the one sponsoring this competition. So I am gonna ask a question, and I will expect you to give me the answer if you know the correct answer. And like I said, it is only for people in Biafra land. There is a reason why we are doing that. But if you are from every other place and you want to answer, you are welcome, but bear in mind that the price only goes to those in Biafra land, because we want to support them. We want to appreciate them for their efforts. Not that other people are not putting in efforts, but those in Biafra land, I can tell you, they put more effort. They are the ones who die. They are the ones who pay the ultimate price. They are the ones who put their life online at every time. As you may know, I mean, look at our ESN, our men in the war front, our men who put their life online every single day. They sleep in bush. They've abandoned their bedroom. They've abandoned their beautiful bed. And now the bushes is now where they sleep. Igemelia, can you afford to do that? Trust me, it is not easy, and it doesn't come cheap. This is the price that people pay for their country. This is the price of freedom. The price that our comrades pay every day and night to ensure that Biafra is restored and to ensure that Biafra land is secured as well. So, it is History Month here on People of the East. Coming up shortly, and I will give out a question as well. I will tell you what number to call, and when you call, you will give me the answer. But now, like I said, it is my first broadcast of the year, and of course, I will take this as my opening speech. But before I do that, it is from the studios, People of the East Radio, Biafra Sadek. We are saying a happy new year to Biafrans all around the world. Kana tokwa oche makana tabu 18th of January. Manonyokwa nuchole ima. Ato mi mamchi mama agabe ima. We are doing our things the way we do it, because we are Biafrans. We have no program. We have no, order of program. We just do it anyhow. We are freedom fighters. No, you know, program at all. We just do it the way we can. Most of our brothers are living in the bush. Can you imagine that? And we are sleeping in our beautiful bed, in our comfortable bed. And I want to ask you this morning, what have you done for our gallant soldiers? What have you done for our gallant security men and women who have left the comfort of their home, and today they are in the bush to ensure that me and you who are in diaspora, our home is secured, our mothers are secured. I mean, now you can even go home and sleep with your two eyes open, because the way Henemen ESN no bonk, my goodness me, it is Magic Chukwuanoha once again, and I'm still saying Happy New Year. And then we continue, of course, it is still Radio Biafra Sadek. My name is Mazi Kechukwu Onoha. They call me the voice that speak for the people on Onukurora. And coincidentally, that is exactly my surname, Ikechukwu Onoha. Onoha. My goodness me. And of course, you can imagine. And this morning, that is what we are doing. Speaking the gospel according to the restoration of Biafra. Speaking the gospel of truth. We swear an oath to tell the truth and nothing but the truth, so help me Chukwu Kikabiama. This is the oath that we have taken as IPOBians, not to betray the gospel, not to betray the struggle, not to betray our leader, not to betray our fellow comrade. We must continue, because Biafra is our last hope. Biafra is our last bus stop, and this morning we have come to do justice to just that. And I welcome you if you are joining us right now. And of course, my name once again is Mazi Kechukwu Onoha. My goodness me, I have no other job, I have no other thing to do except to work on this restoration of Biafra, because this is ultimate, this is more important. All the things we know in life, they are important, I understand, but trust me, you cannot compare this, you cannot compare the restoration of struggle of Biafra with any other thing. And this morning, this is what we have come to do. My name is Mazi Kechukwu Onoha, and it is an early morning breakfast. What are you waiting for? Join the conversation right now. The song rises from the rise. And the wise men and the wise from the keys. This is Radio Biafra Sadek. Biafra Johannesburg is where you are. We are the people of the East. What are you waiting for? Join the interaction. If you have not joined, if you are still listening or not listening, I want you on board right now, because together we are going to make this program a worldwide. We are going to do this together. The restoration effort of Biafra is not a one man's job. It is a united effort. United will stand and divided will fall. And this morning, that is exactly what we are going to do. If you have not joined us, please join us. We are on every platform. We are on IPOB Community Radio. Of course, Radio Biafra is the first and the last. We are also on Facebook. You can get us on Facebook, Radio Biafra. That's where we are, streaming live to humanity. So if you have not joined, please do just that right now, so that you can join us and begin to proclaim this gospel according to the restoration of the sovereign state of Biafra. My name is Mazi Kechukwu Onoha. My goodness me. And of course, here we are doing the work that Elohim have asked us to do. All right. I am live. I am direct on Facebook. Like I say, you can join the interaction now. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give out the numbers that you are going to call, because very soon I will open the line so that we can get cracking. And I'm going to ask a question. If you get it right, we will give you a voucher. We will give you a voucher. And you ask me, what voucher are you talking about? We will give you an airtime voucher, which you can convert to buy a data, because we know we also need a data day by day to do this work. Therefore, we are going to do give you a recharge card voucher, and then of course you will use it. That is if you get my question correct. Like I said, the conditions of the competition is that you must be in Biafra land. Only those those in Biafra land will win this. But you are also welcome anywhere you are to join us. Of course, we will not forbid you. But just bear in mind that only those in Biafra land are the ones who are going to win this prize. All right, let's get straight to it. The numbers to call as soon as I open the line are as follows. You can call us on our main line, +27 632 721 255, +27 632 721 255. We are also on WhatsApp live and direct. You can call us on WhatsApp +27 740 67 8412. I repeat, +27 740 678 412. For the last time, our WhatsApp numbers are +27 740 678 412. We are also live and direct on Skype, Radio Biafra Sadek. Radio Biafra is one word, of course, Sadek. My goodness me. So we are everywhere. And of course, you can catch us everywhere. Hashtag we move. Hashtag we move. Unbelievable. Because we are unstoppable. All right, let's get straight to it. This is my opening statement. I want to talk a little bit because of time, and I'm going to just go straight to the lines. I want to talk a little bit about what happened during the week. Of course, they had this thing they call Never Again. It's a Zoom meeting. It is called Never Again. It was hosted by Dele Momodu, of course, who I think he is a good journalist. He's a renowned journalist, the only man standing as far as the zoo is concerned in terms of journalism at the moment. Of course, because I don't have anything against him in terms of the way he conducts himself as a journalist. They conducted this thing they call Never Again. We know last year or last 2 years, I'm not sure, they did the same thing again, you know, where you had Onyeka Onwenu, you know, and others coming out to speak about Biafra, not really Biafra, but mostly about the Igbos and how they are being treated in the zoo called Nigeria. So this year again, they had the same thing. Now, luckily, our leader also participated. If you had watched it online, you should have heard our leader spoken. And of course, he came out and did justice to what he had to do and tell them the way it is. But now, for me, there is something that happened in that Zoom meeting. There is something that happened in that hashtag Never Again they did. I don't know what it is that they're saying never again, but trust me when I tell you, from where I'm seated, where I'm standing or sitting, whatever the case may be, it is not never again, because it's going to happen again. I can promise you that it is going to happen again. So never again is just rubbish. For me, it is going to happen again. So now, the highlight for me of that junk Never Again program they had, my highlight is this. There is a woman. What is the name of this woman? She says she is from the Middle Belt. That's what she said. She says she's from the Middle Belt, this woman. My goodness me. You should have listened to this woman. She finished the Igbos. She finished the Biafrans. You know, what she said was a bit upsetting if you listen to it. Some people will be so upset. But I kind of like what she said. I kind of like it. Do you know why I like it? She told us the truth. The truth that everybody is running away from. The truth that the so-called Janjaweed knot is painting. You know, painting it so nicely with sweet tongues. The truth the so-called zoo is running away from. This woman, Okowarako Yibun Sube, what did she say? After our leader has spoken, Onyeka Onwenu has spoken, Paayo Adebanjo has spoken, and they are all spoke well, you know, about where we stand with the issue of the zoo and Biafra and what have you. This woman came out and said she is sick and tired of the Igbos playing victim in Nigeria. She is sick and tired of Onyeka Onwenu, Amazi Nnamdi Kanu coming up here, telling them they are going to separate, they are going to leave, they are going to go. She is sick and tired of Biafrans playing the host. She said a lot of things, and I would advise you to go and listen. Now let me tell you, in as much as you hated what that woman said, that woman is telling you exactly how the zoo feels about you. This is exactly how the zoo, the north, the zoo as a country feels about the so-called Igbo presidency and co. That is how the zoo feels about the so-called Biafra and whatever. They don't like you. They hate you with all perfect hatred. You see what they are doing? These guys are playing games with your mind. They will come and say, oh, hashtag never again, but they are still killing you. Hashtag never again, but Fulani Janjaweed is killing non-stop, and they're saying to you never again. And I'm asking, never again what? Are you saying never again the killing? Because the killing haven't stopped. The killing is still going on, and they're telling you never again. And some stupid so-called Igbo leaders, they came out there on the public and national television and, you know, making a fool out of themselves. I was disappointed with Peter Obi. He was there, but Peter Obi said nothing. He was speaking, actually, but Peter Obi said nothing. He called himself elite. Does Peter Obi understand the meaning of elites? People voted you to be where you are, and you are calling yourself elite. I don't understand. He even said that they, the elite, must gather and decide how they are going to take the country forward, blah, 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 blah. Now, these people have forgotten what democracy is all about. It is government of the people, by the people, for the people. It is the people who decide, not the so-called useless rubbish elites. And I like what our leader told Peter Obi, even though he didn't mention his name, but we know who he's talking about, the so-called elite. I was so disappointed with what Peter Obi said. He came out there talking about elite nonsense, elite garbage. The one they call Utomi, is it Professor Utomi or whatever his name is? He came out there speaking like a politician, as if he's talking to kids of 10 years old. Telling us how he was on phone with Obasanjo for 1 hour. What the hell has that got to do with Mazi Kechukwuonoha? He came there talking crap, absolutely crap. I must give it to this woman. What's her name? Engo Briggs. I don't know if I'm getting her name. Engo Briggs. She spoke it the way it is. She spoke like a Biafran. Because when you listen from her, you know what she was saying. She spoke. All right. I'm getting some interruption here. If you will bear with me, I need to sort this out. All right. As I was saying, she came out and she spoke like a Biafran. She is. And that is what we expect of our people. Please give me a second. Let me sort this out. Please. All right. 1 second, please. There we go. All right. Sorry about that. As I was speaking, Engelbreed came on board and she spoke like a Biafran. But that woman was a highlight for me. My goodness me. Even Dele Momodu has to call her to order in a nice way and tell her that there is no need for her to be upset. And, you know, in other words, she is telling her there is no need to be talking, you know, the way she is talking against the Igbos and the Biafrans. Our so-called elders are there talking nonsense. So what do you expect from this woman? Of course she is going to insult us. Because people insult the so-called Igbos, the so-called Biafrans, whenever they feel like, because our so-called elders have already insulted themselves. So that was a highlight of the week for me. And of course, this is what I have to say this morning, you know, in terms of my opening statement. But our leader, thank heavens, came there and Kwako Igbo Nsugbe, he told them just the way it is, without drawing any punches. He just said it the way it is. And it is high time our people need to understand, when they say to you there is no war, run for your life because there is war. When they say to you never again, run for your life because it is just getting started. I will just say something in that, you know, meeting that I picked up. He say that these Fulanis are very tricky. They pretend and let you understand and believe that there is peace, whereas they are putting you in a corner and they are busy dealing with you. But of course, we know our people are so greedy. For them, it's all about Igbo presidency nonsense. It is the turn of my village. We must go for it. We must go and eat our own money. But we are saying as Biafrans, power belongs to the people. And it is time for us to rise up and tell them the zoo must cease to exist. My name is Mazi Ikechukwu Onoha. And of course, this is Radio Biafra Sadek. And this is my opening statement. Out the number, and then of course I'm gonna tell you the question so that we can get cracking. The numbers to call is +27 632 721 255, +27 632 721 255. That is our main line. And of course our WhatsApp number as follows: +27 740 678 412, +27 740 678 412. For the last time, our WhatsApp number is +27 740 678 412, or you can call us on Skype, Radio Biafra Sadek. Radio Biafra is one word. It is Radio Biafra Sadek. All right, that is the number to call. And of course, I'm gonna ask the question. If you know the answer, you call me and you will walk away with a prize if you get it right. It is History Month here on People of the East. We are telling our story, our people, our story here on People of the East. All right, let's see, what do we have this morning? The question is actually easy. It's pretty easy. Please, no cheating. All right, who is banging on my door? My goodness me. All right, I need to get this quiet. Very, very important. It is making a hell of noise. Unbelievable. All right, so this is our WhatsApp line. And the people are already calling, and I need to sort this out. My goodness me. All right. I think I get it sorted out. All right, let's continue. I'm trying to see how I can sort this out, but of course we must continue. So the question this morning is very simple. If you know the question, please give me a call right away and give me the answer. The question today in history, of course, this is the question. Very, very simple. The first shot of the Nigerian Civil War we are fired in 1967. All right, so what month, because of course 1967 is a given, that's why I'm even calling it. Even if I don't say 1967, you know of course that the war was fought in 1967. So the first shot of the Nigerian Civil War was fired in 1967. Now I'm asking you, what month, what day of the month was it fired, and where, which town was it fired at? Let me start again. The question goes like this. The first shot of the 1967 Biafran Nigerian Civil War was fired in 1967. That we know. But where, which day of 1967 was it fired? Which day of the month? I need the day, I need the month, I need the town where it happened. And I also need the local government area where it happened. All right, let's make it very simple. Let's make it very easy for us so that we don't get confused. I'm saying today in history, the first shot of the Nigerian Biafran Civil War was fired in 1967. All right, get that, we know. Now I'm asking you, which day and which month, which day and which month was this fired? You know, like the date of the, you know, the date of that month, which date of the month was it fired? And I need to know, where was it fired? Which town was it fired? Which local government was it fired? And which province in Biafra land was it fired. My goodness me, this is going to be cracker. I don't want to make it easy for you. I want to crack your brain. I want to test your intelligence. I want to test your understanding of our history. Very, very important. I don't want to make it so easy for you to come up here and tell me, okay, it happened on this day and that is it. No, you need to know all of them. Very, very important. And that is to show how intelligent you are when it comes to Biafra history. So, it happened in 1967, we all know. But I'm asking you, I need the date when it happened. I need the month when it happened. And I need to know the town where it happened. And I need to know the local government where it happened. And I need to know in which province did it happen. So, we have about how many questions in one? We have one, which is the date. Two, which is the month. Three, which is the local, which is the town, I beg your pardon. Four, the local government. And five, the province in Biafra land. Please don't be angry with me. You will say, Mazi Kechu, ni wele ukwago, kezi nkewu, ibuko shiri question nila, ya jodia. No, kete siya yo brain, okay, amana hafa. Alright, let's get it started. Let's get it cracking and know what is happening. Caller on WhatsApp, can you hear me?
Mazi Kechu,
good morning. Like good morning.
Mazi, my name is Mazi Akas. I'm calling from Austria.
They were watching like
it. So Mazi, you said it does in diaspora. Even if we answer, we're not going to win.
Yes, because you're supposed to be sponsoring the competition. I can't give anything away to somebody in diaspora. Please go ahead.
I agree with you, Mazi. Mazi, Happy New Year.
I wish you the same, Wachineke. Come on again, ma.
Yes, Mazi, we've been longing to hear your voice all this while.
Here I am.
We thank God you are back. And,
thank you very much.
We'll be hearing from you.
Absolutely.
Hopefully we'll be hearing from you from now.
Absolutely.
Mazi, the truth is that the question you asked, please, if you can allow me, I will beg you that the question really, I can't really answer it.
Why not? Why not, Mazi?
Yes. No, Mazi, yeah, I can answer the one I can answer here. I don't know the local government. I don't know the village where it happened.
All right, give us what you know. Give us what you know. Very, very important. Give us what you know.
Mazi, I know that the first shot was on February. But the date I don't know. But I know it's February. I can tell you it's February. Mazi, I want to be honest with myself. You know.
Mazi, Eweliwe, hold on. Do you know Zebodiah? Do you know Zebodiah Okorigbemoko?
Yes.
He normally says,
yes.
Fa 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 foul. Please go ahead.
Absolutely. From primary to secondary, they never knew where they taught, they teach anything about Biafra. So, Mazi, please, forgive us if some of us cannot answer it. But okay. I have my, what I want to comment in your topic today, because I followed right from beginning. Concerning this woman, and this never again.
Yes.
You know, Mazi, when you hear some people talking about this never again, I feel so sorry for these people, because I don't know where they're coming from. Whether they are breathing from their anus or they are breathing from, I don't know. How can somebody open their mouth and be talking rubbish? But the truth is that it's good for us to be knowing this thing, because if your enemy or if you're somebody who's against you cannot be able to tell you those things that you never expect from him, then who know where you are going? It's good for us to be having it's like a woman
Mazi, listen. Mazi, listen, eh? Before we die, listen. You know that woman who spoke on that never again? My goodness me. She if I have a prize, I will give her. I'm talking about the woman who insulted the Igbos and the Biafra. You know why I love her so much? She told us the truth. You know that program was actually a fake program to make us feel like we belong, to make us look like they are bringing us back into Nigeria. Now that woman told us what is in the heart of the so-called middle belt, the so-called northerners or what have you. They don't love you. No, we are sick and tired of you people. This is exactly how the whole average one Nigerianist feels about the Igbos. But then, unfortunately, our people are ne ipoku kandi beribe ndi ishi. You know, na one cycle, we call it one cycle. Na cycle ndina cho gacho. So I love what that woman said. To be honest with you, please go ahead and summarize for me.
Yes, Mazi, thank you so much. Really, and it's unfortunate that the woman that is saying this thing, she's a girlfriend. But ignorantly, she decided to turn back to her own people. I thank God for what is happening today, Mazi. Even if you watch when our leader was answering the questions of Dele Momodu, even the last question, the last question Dele Momodu asked our leader was answering this question. Do you know the heat of the question? Dele cannot be able to contain it anymore. What he did was, he said, only tell our leader, okay, please, let's leave it, then we'll have conversation one-on-one, because a lot of difficult questions that Dele Momodu cannot even ask those of them that are never again. But he can be able to ask it to our leader. You know, Mazin Nambikano have shown us the light. This man has brought light that today all of us can be well educated when it comes in terms of anything concerning Biafra. So Mazin, in my conclusion, and I want to thank you for coming out again once in this year to begin what you know how to do best. And we urge you, please Mazin, we always been hungry to hear from you. Please, make time to always talk to your people, because your voice is like, you know, I can remember even last year there was a day, Mazi, I don't know, anything you are doing here, we don't forget to Mazi.
Thank you very much.
You were in a program when you were in Israel, you were in a program, and there's a woman that you wanted to invite that day. Mazi, do you know that when you started this program, Mazi, you are like, somebody arrested you. I will never forget that day.
Thank you very much.
You were speaking to the extent that even when we are waiting to hear when you are going to call the woman, Mazi, the Holy Spirit takes you. So,
thank you very much.
Someone who wants to be hearing from you, Mazi, please keep on coming online so that we'll be interacting with you. May Elohim to go carry him and bless you and bless our leader, Mazi Nambikano, and give us all the fortitude we need this year to make sure that Biafra will come.
Thank you very much, Mazi. All hail Biafra. All right, thank you, my brother. You have spoken excellently well, and of course, we welcome that. I'm trying to take this call. Let's see if we can get this. Caller on the main line, can you hear me? Caller on the main line, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Chineke. Please go ahead. Humanity is listening.
My name is Akati Bebe. I'm calling from Benue State.
Yes, go ahead.
So please, I want to answer the question.
By all means.
Okay. So the first shot was shot on June. So, and it was Ngakem. The Kwanaka government.
Is that all? Is that all? All right, we have lost that caller, but I can say the first answer, he said it was in June. All I can say to him is fa 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 foul. And then the second one, he's saying Ngakem, and then of course I'm not gonna say whether he's true or false, but he got the first one wrong, and that means he is out. of the competition. We must continue. We are the people of the South. Know your history. If you know your history, you will know who you are. You will know where you are coming from, and you will know where you are going. Hit me with the answer this morning. I'm asking you, first in history, where was the first shot of the Nigerian Biafran Civil War fired? In which town? What month? What date? In which local government? And of course, in which province of Biafra land? It is not going to be easy, but if you have the brain to comprehend our history, I want you to come up this morning and challenge me and tell me what you know about Biafra history. My goodness me. On a request, I see the hot this morning. All right. Hello, we must continue. Morning. What is going on? What is good going morning, on? Sir. All right, Mazi, hold on for me. Is that a caller on WhatsApp? Is that the caller on WhatsApp?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, I'm the caller on WhatsApp.
Good morning. Go ahead, Mazi. People are listening. Humanity are listening. Ebenilo Wasotoro. Go ahead, please.
Okay, let me first of all greet my people with my language. Could you permit me?
By all means, Mazi. By all means, Ichiteba Rowanile. Go ahead.
Ekele kamon do munem onyelezire semorono no mototo no no mayase ayahuke ayahu ejinde umukele jeni ona sofia umukele jeni masna de kalo wawadi ogo prof onu le chala no no ande ipbc no no mototo no no mayase biafra de kabia ekaba ye
Mazi, is that agbo language?
Yeah, it's Agbo.
Damn, I'm good. I thought as much. Please go ahead.
Okay. The question is that you said where did the first shot was taken?
Fired. Yes. Yes. When was it fired?
It was on the 12th May, 1967. I think Calabar, something like that. Ugoja, the name of the town is Ugoja.
All right.
Am I correct?
Do you want me to give you your results? Because I exam killer here. He just took your exam. Do you want your result?
Yeah.
fa.
No. The first shot was Ugoja on the 12th of May, 1967.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
Now we are sounding like Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Mazi, you got it wrong, unfortunately. I'm sorry about that. We cannot change the history, but I will give you straight the answer I have at the end of the program, or if somebody got it right. Thank you very much for trying, Ndewo.
Thank you, Ndo.
All right. Thank you, my brother. Of course, let's see if the second person will give us the correct answer. Let's call her on WhatsApp. Please go ahead. Call her on Skype. Hold on. I will come to you right now. Mazi, you need to turn off your radio. Call her on WhatsApp. Turn off your radio, please. Please turn off your radio. Mazi.
Good morning.
Yes, good morning from here.
And my name is...
Turn off your radio, Mazi. Turn off your radio. Or move away from
it. I'm hearing you.
Go ahead.
Good morning.
Good morning from here.
My name is Edechi Gozi. I'm calling from Anambra on Onitsha side.
They were on Onitsha though. Please go ahead.
Okay, concerning the question, one name Ejora, Ebe Biafra no Bido Baog.
Yes, the first shot, where was it fired?
It was fired at Ondo State in July 15. Hello.
Yes, I'm listening to you. I'm listening.
It was fired at Ondo in July 15, sir.
Mazi, are you telling me that hey, are you trying to Ondo fire shot? Mazi, that was foul. We all know that the war started in Biafra land. What you can consign Ondo with the first shot? Alright, we must continue. On have come to your tree. One next long I won't do cabra the airway. I won't know the games in the fire one shot. So I will like capture go Lagos and Zubozubon. Alright, let's continue. It is Radio Biafra Slat Deck. It is getting hot. I see the hot for this studio. Now saw me at the carry fan, the fan myself, because on a remere, it all hot, it don't ready, don't pepe. Wait till you carry a bear carry and come. Now history month 9 with this so with a talk about Biafra. We want to know as it they happen. Wait till you know. If you don't know, go ask your papa, go ask your grandpapa, grandmama, mama, they go tell you waiting day. Because history, now in they tell us who we be. Alright, let's go to Skype. I think I have a caller on Skype holding. Caller on Skype, if you can hear me, good morning.
Yeah, good morning. I can hear you loud and clear, Marty.
Alright, take it away. Biafra are listening.
Yes, good morning. I greet dear friends all over the world, friends of Biafra, lovers of freedom. I salute you, our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Good morning from me. I salute you.
Thank you very much.
I'm Rabbi Charles. I'm speaking from my location.
Longest time, Mazi.
I'm seeing you on Facebook.
Mazi, Happy New Year. Happy Easter. Happy New Christmas. Year,
Happy New Year. God bless you.
God bless you too.
I'm reading every of the comment, everything.
Thank you very much.
I am admiring everything in Tewosa.
Please go ahead.
I'm not calling to answer your question because it's not made for me because I'm not a Zoo right now.
All right, go ahead, please.
Any of your followers must know that you have asked this question about 2 years ago.
Yes, of course. Thank you very much for reminding me.
Yes. So just to refresh our memory, I'm not going to participate in it.
Thank you.
I know the answer because it was dealt with on your program.
Absolutely.
Before you left for Israel.
You're right.
So I want to ask you questions, sir, please.
Okay. What is my prize, please? What is my prize before you ask me a question? Because I'm giving out something for my own question. So you know, go just ask me a question without my own prize. please go ahead. I'm just kidding. Go ahead.
Yeah. Price will be discussed off air.
Okay.
Let me ask this. Why do you think that woman that made such alteration must be commended or you appreciate? I know what you meant, but I want Biafran to understand exactly where you are coming from before they think that you meant it can be ironical statement you are making.
Yes.
But I want people to understand what you meant by saying that she must, you know, be commended, that you admire her. Just explain to us.
All right.
Yes, please.
All right. Very simple. I'm not going to take it long. I'm just going to make it brief and short. Now, you adopted a child, okay? And that child is not your child. And you don't want to tell that child the truth. So every day the child goes out and that child is shouting, beating up other children in the village. You know, that child believes he's the heir of the kingdom. He's untouchable. And one day, one child also stood up to him. Even though everybody was lying to that child, including the parents, including the villagers, they were all lying to him and said, you are the son of this person. But one day in school, one child stood up and said to that child, you are a bastard. And that child said, what? That child cried and went home and said to the parent, why have you been lying to me? So you are not my real parent. So that is the scenario that played out yesterday. You know, she said something, that woman, that we are playing the ostrich. What is the ostrich? We put our head in the sand and pretend that everything is good, whereas everything is not good. So this is actually Elohim speaking to Biafrans, telling them, you don't belong here. This is not your country. You are actually like a bastard in this country. Your home is somewhere. Go and find your home. For me, it is Elohim speaking that true woman. So, because remember, the whole idea of that program was to paint a picture that everything is good, never again. But there comes the one Nigerian telling us, hey, don't say never again, it's going to happen again. You guys, we have had enough of you. You can go if you want. Please go ahead. That is my own understanding of that woman's statement.
Great. I now can get what you are saying very clearly now.
Thank you very much.
I have, yes, of course, because we have different ways of approaching matters or solving or having understanding about statements. Somebody can make statement right now in the presence of 10 people, but those 10 people, it will mean different things to them.
Absolutely.
When you ask them to write it, they will write it in a different perspective as how they perceive it. So I, for what I got from the woman, that actually woke me up. I lashed out on her on so many programs, and I am doing the same thing even right now. I'm going to do the same thing. You have been in Israel, in the state of Israel. You've lived there. Now tell me, I want to ask you this: can anyone, any minister or any public figure or a renowned person in the world today, maybe president, prime minister, or diplomat of any country, come to any platform and said Holocaust did not exist? Why are you guys playing victim mentality, like you are victimized? Look at me also. I am from the Middle Belt. I am not in the northern area, but they grouped me as part of the north. We are having issue with them because we are Middle Belters. We are not northerners. We are not northerners, and they put me there. Now you can't quantify that your scenario with genocide, where people got killed. A lot of people got killed. This is my analysis. I got mad, but I'm happy that our leader, each time our leader is in any platform or forum, I will relax, because he speaks our mind. He will say exactly how I feel.
All right.
In my mind.
Pastor Charles, Rabbi Charles,
yes.
Rabbi Charles,
yes.
Let me say something quickly. Now, Israel is a different scenario compared with that of the zoo. I tell you why. Remember, Israel is not a free nation. They are one people. And all the people you see living there, majority believe that Israel should exist, that Israel is a nation. We know there are few who might be against the whole thing. You understand? So you will rarely hear such statement in Israel, especially in the national television or wherever. Now, on the case of the zoo, remember, this is still another man's country, where our so-called foolish elders are still claiming that they belong. So now and then you will see Elohim speaking to us through some people to tell us the truth. Do not be deceived. Nigeria does not belong to you. For me, the way I see that word, that woman is staring us. That anger you have now is what we need, because when you have that anger, it will make you to hate the zoo more. It will make you to work harder to ensure that we are out of that contraption. It will also make you to understand that when they say peace, peace, sudden war comets. So if you look at it, it's a different perspective. You cannot be in another man's country and you're coming out asking for Igbo presidency 2023. It is not your country, for crying out loud. Please go ahead.
Okay, yes, I get you right. But remember, there was a time a president of Iran, former president Ahmadinejad, who was pictured in one of the terrorist attacks in the embassy of United States in Tehran. And in those days, back in the days, his picture was captured there, that he was one of the terrorists that attacked America in their embassy. But he's denying it. He said he's not. He's a look-alike. The same president Ahmadinejad said that the Holocaust theory is not a true story, that there wasn't anything like Holocaust. I wash out what Israelis did to him. Now they unleash mayhem, and they're still unleashing mayhem to Tehran today. Now when somebody, a public figure, comes to tell us, who is still presently serving in the Nigerian government, come to tell Biafran that Igbos, she was referring to Biafran, that we are playing victims mentality, that we are saying that we are victimized. We are not really victimized. That was what she was saying, that we are not victimized, that we are not the only people that are being victimized. You cannot qualify that thing with their being marched to the northerner or northern states as the people in Biafra being killed. So when
But now, yes. What do you actually expect from a zoo person or a one Nigerianist to come and tell you, oh, Biafrans, we love you. We know we killed you people. Yes. We are so sorry. Do you really expect that?
No, sir, I don't expect.
Thank you very much.
Let me say this. I will be brief. In the presence of Antio Briggs, who is a Biafran that denying they are not Biafrans, but Ojukwu fought the war, they were inclusive in that war. Okay? In the presence of our lady, our beloved sister, Mrs. Onye Konwenu, she was there. No respect. In the presence of, okay, Your Excellency, the former governor of Anambra State, Peter Obi, was there. And this woman does not have respect and regard on those people. And in the presence of our leader, above all, she knows that Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu was there. And you see the way she mentioned his name. I got up.
No, Mazi, are you still there? Are you still there, Mazi? Mazi, listen,
I'm here.
I think our leader was actually vindicated. Trust me, our leader will not even be upset. Our leader will be actually happy, because this is what he has been telling us all along. If you serve the zoo, you will come back disgraced. These people don't love you. So isn't it better that it came out from the horse's mouth, and with the so-called one Nigeria list, they heard her loud and clear? For me, I love it, because if our leader keep on saying they don't love you, they hate you, and you haven't heard it from the zoo themselves, you will think our leader is doing what? Stirring up the polity. So for me,
I got your point.
Mm.
I got your point. I know what you meant. You meant that she her insult to us must provoke us.
Thank you very much.
That's what you meant. That's why I want to. That is the reason why I want to clarify this to our people, that you meant that insult must provoke us.
Thank you very much.
Said that since Israelis does not want to accept Jesus Christ, he will use the Gentiles to provoke them into jealousy. He said that in his word. So God is using her to provoke us, to give us a kind of pain. That is the pain I got. I said this woman must be reprimanded for her to come up to say that the theory of a genocide, of massacring Biafran, shouldn't be anything that we shouldn't play victim on that. We are playing victim.
All right,
like, we are the only one that is being victimized. She must be reprimanded for that, for saying such a thing, because she will pay the heavy price for that. I'm telling you.
Thank you very
much. As long as Biafran nation is, she must pay the price. Not now, she will pay it later. Mazin there was
a Chineke. Thank you very much, Mazi. I welcome that. Of course, you know, I love this. You know, it is called a constructive argument. Constructive argument. But like I said, I love what she said. I love the fact that she told us straight up, you don't belong here. Go and get your own country. There is no better way to tell us that than on the national television, than on a national platform. Because remember, the whole idea of Never Again was to confuse us the more. Every year they come up with this nonsense. Every year they come up with this rubbish, Never Again, pretending that they love us, pretending that there's no more war, where they are still busy killing us. And some stupid if we're happy, they are talking about Biafra issue. Whereas in their heart, I want us to know they hate you perfect with passion. And Chineke na web metwani aka ya we megono ya na nyu ahorna wagefa to provoke you to anger, to understand that you don't belong, to understand that you are an adopted child in the zoo called Nigeria, to provoke you that you are a slave in Nigeria. In as much as what she said is upsetting, trust me when I tell you, my goodness me, I love what she said, because it is high time that we are told who we are. It is high time we are provoked. It is high time our leader, Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu, is vindicated, because time and after time, our leader has told us, they don't love you. All right, let's go to another caller. I think I have a caller on WhatsApp. Let me check that. But of course, I do commend Rabbi Charles. You know, he provoked, you know, this argument, and it is a healthy one indeed. Of course, this is how it should be. We argue like learned people. We argue like Biafrans, of course, in order at the end of the day to come out with a constructive understanding. All right, we must continue. Of course, our competition still continues. I know it is a hard one. Chineke Kulihonjo, this question is Oporonko Otaranko. And he says, today in history, the first shot of the Nigerian Civil War was fired in 1967. And I'm asking you, what date what month, what town, what local government, and what province in Biafra land. My brother said it's in Ondo. I'm not fire a first shot in Ondo. I want Ondo get the dog. Trust me, in those days we fought, we should have been in Lagos, capturing Lagos. I can tell you if that was the case, but that wasn't the case. All right. Caller on Skype, if you can hear me, people of the East, good morning.
Yeah, good morning, my beloved brother Ike.
No, I wish you the same, my brother. Please go ahead. Now, for you, a woman. Go ahead, please.
We have to protect our leader. We need the karma lot. So, go karma is it?
Omremezu.
We appreciate even our volunteers all over the world, the leadership, the US, all of them, every fanatical men of valor. Men of valor, radical Biafras, to go they're connected. People who are called for this journey, who are coming to your strength. Mazi, like Rabbi Chas rightly said, you see, Mazi, what that woman was trying to signal that, to tell her that we are still a conquered people.
Thank you very much. And I love it.
Yeah, they just want to see, want to tell her that we are still a conquered people. That I want to hide with Allah. But I always said, we don't need to talk too much. Mazi, you're working at Medianobi, Allah. Onyendu is ready to defend us at any time, any point in that. People came and brought him, and we are solidly behind them. Those of us that are caught for this struggle, those of us that are reincarnated from 1967 to now, they killed us, and they continue to know that we are still conquered. There is no too much talking in the evening gospel. When the time comes, we'll cross it to Mazi. Mazi, man, a question about a cracky.
That is all.
Of course, you're not for us. What we are going to do, let our people continue to answer the question. But like you rightly said, Mazi, if you want to know your meds, if you want to know your history, Mazi, I don't know Casey now. You know, those days when we the village, I will Mwena, we told I who Netona, Laneke, Ola. Then if you want to know where you belong, they will tell you a story you will never believe. My brother, Mazi, we appreciate you once again.
Thank you very much.
We appreciate you. Let our people continue to answer the question. You have asked it the last 2 years.
Absolutely.
Come and get it. Mama, we are Biafrans.
All right, thank you very much, my brother. Okay, foreigners, you work at all right. My goodness me, we must continue. It is to Radio Biafra Sadek. We are the people of the East, of course, taking your calls this morning as well as going into our competition. And I want to thank our brother who have actually sponsored this competition. I'm talking about our brother Simon Anyo. My brother, this is your son name, something like that. You know, he actually said I need to sponsor this, and of course we expect you, if you want to sponsor the competition as well, please inbox me. You know how to get me. It's Mike Biafra Obi. Mike Biafra Obi, that is my name on Facebook, Mike Biafra Obi. You can invoice me on Facebook, Mike Biafra Obi, and tell me how you want to sponsor this competition. Of course, we are doing this competition in order to assist our people back home in Biafra land. You know, that's why we say it is only for those in Biafra land. At least they can get some data to listen to the gospel according to the restoration of Biafra. We know how things are so difficult there in the zoo. Our people back home, they buy data every day in order to listen to Radio Biafra. And you know, life is tough. So if you can help, if you can assist, inbox me, Mike Biafra OB. And of course, we don't need your, you know, need you to send us money or whatever, but we'll tell you what to do, how it will work out. Anything you want to use to, you know, sponsor the competition will go straight to the winner back in Biafra land. And of course, we don't really handle cash when it comes to money. We will not tell you to send us money here on People of the East. We don't do that, Makada Makwama. But we will tell you how it is going to happen, because when you sponsor the competition, of course, it means whatever is the price of the day, you say, okay, for this week, for this month, I'm going to take care of it. All right, let us take this call. And no, maybe this caller have the answer for us. Who knows? Caller on WhatsApp, can you hear me?
Good morning.
Good morning from here, Mazindewo.
Okay. My name is Simon.
Ayanogwo. Ayanogwo. Okay, now I get it.
Yeah, my grandfather told me about it when I was 6 years old, because I was told that everybody hated me. Nobody liked me when I was born, because I'm a nature. So I asked my granddad, why is it like this? Yeah, some special people.
I get it.
Nobody love lion in the jungle.
Absolutely.
So, let me just straight to the point. I saw the question he asked. You know, our people, more like as he said about the program, the question answer, and I can see it. I think everybody know it. I think even me, I know it itself. You understand? But you see that the way it's going is like, I don't know it. Put our lost or not. So this such program is good to motivate our people. At least people in Biafra land that doesn't have don't normally have credit. We can just do something, you know, but I think you will be in more position to direct me how it's supposed to go. At least if we can be giving them voucher of credit or whatever, I think, in my opinion, I think it will be okay.
Absolutely. That is what we are going to be giving. It's going to be a recharge voucher, you know, to help the person convert it into data, you know, so that they can use it to go to Facebook to propagate the gospel, and also as well to listen to Radio Biafra. Please go ahead.
Yeah, because we need to educate our young ones. But I see this, our generation do not wipe out people that were born after the war, and people that we are within during the time of the war. At least there was a time in Nigeria those days, more especially that year 2015, when they were arrested our leader, because some people didn't know what was going on. But when they arrested him, a lot of things start happening. When they see you with the Biafra regal or whatever, people ask you questions, both home and abroad those days. There was a place, Oman asked me, do you know what is Biafra? Do you know what is Biafra? How old are you? Yeah, this and that. I was just looking at him. You know, these Nigerian people, when they see themselves, they attack themselves elite or attack themselves whoever they are. People are contributing to pay. People sweat. People cry. People stand in the sun. Only whoever you are. And they go over there, you say you're elite. I know how to handle them. I have some friends of them. So one man was asking me, do you know what Biafra is? Do you know if it is real? It's just something made up with Ojukwu and some of his group. I just allow him. I did not, because I don't know how to start much. I said, have you finished, sir? He said, yes. I said, okay. Have you ever heard the history of Biafra before? He said, no, it's 1967. Ojukwu, he said, that man talking to me, you know, smoking like, you know, this thing they tag us. We don't have respect. We are other than this and that. You know, when you are wise, more than them, they call you names. I just respect him. And this was happening in airport, oh. This was happening in airport. So, after I said, do you know about the history of Biafra? Thank God of internet and social media, I bring out the history of Biafra for him. Up to 17th century. Mazi Ikechukwu, do you know this? ancient Gotham, ancient world map like 1475. Guardian should be after. It is in Vatican to tomorrow. So this kind of the thing was the thing I bring. I made man a fool. I made man a fool. And I never knew that what I was doing was when they targeted me next time. Well, because there was a time I have a deal with them. The Chukwu Okike Abiyama saved me with a very miracle work. That's why when I know that this Biafra of a thing we do is more spiritual more than any other thing you can ever talk about in this world, because Chukwu Okike Abiyama have
right.
Seen me that what I'm doing is right.
All right, Mazi.
So anybody should not bully us. Again, the comment you make about this what they call it, the woman from
Middle Belt, she said.
Please, you know, that's why I understand my own thing, because I don't normally follow crowd. That thing, I do not see it as insult. It is wake up call for me, for our people to know, because they think there's something left to scavenge in Nigeria. But my position since 2014, I joined the struggle. There is nothing. Because people ask me, you people, this type of people, we thought you people will do this, do that. Do what for Nigeria? A place that doesn't want us to survive. A place that wants us to die. Bring anything good from our place. Say you want to establish anything good in Biafra land. The Nigerian government will say no. It happened to me in 2010. When I brought energy company here from Austria here.
Mazi, summarize for me, please.
Well, Mazi, let me leave it here. Our people are talking 2023, and that's why, doesn't mean our people don't have sense. Why would these people use it like this? Do you know how many people they have presented the vice presidency and the president? And our people are buying this crap. That's why they are using them to kill us, but we can't allow them to continue. Mazi, thank you for
giving. Thank you very much, Mazi. They will.
Okay, bless you.
And bless you too.
We'll talk after if you're through, please.
Thank you very much, of course. We welcome that. We thank you, my brother, of course. And we must continue with this to Radio Biafra Sadek. We are the people of the East. In case you are joining us right now and you are somehow lost and you don't know where you are at, here is where you are at.
This is Radio Biafra Sadek. Johannesburg is where you are at. And we are the people of the East.
All right, you got it right. It is people of the East, and it is breakfast with Mazi Ketuku on Loha.
It's breakfast with Mazi Ketuku on Loha. On people of the East, of joys,
we must continue in earnest. Of course, calls are still coming. Let's see if we can get this one. Ma. Caller on the line, if you can hear me, please go ahead. Mazi, are you there?
I'm calling from Anambra State.
They were watching again.
I think 1967, it was a fire at Nsoka, Enugu State. Hello?
Yes, I can hear you. Please go ahead.
Hello?
I can hear you, Mazi. Continue. I can hear you loud and clear.
I said it was fired at Nsoka, Enugu State.
All right. Unfortunately not. Thank you very much. All right, we must continue, and I will appreciate the fact that this is a very serious question indeed, you know, but it is our first time, and I'm trying to make it you know, as easy as it can be. If we don't get an answer today, we will roll it over on Wednesday when we are back again. And on Wednesday, if we don't get an answer on Wednesday, then of course we will tell you the answer, and then we will give you another question. All right, we must continue. I'm just asking a very simple question, and I said that the first shot of Nigerian Civil War was fired in 1967. That is a known fact. But now I'm asking you, which date of the month was it fired, and which month is that as well? Which town, which local government, and which province in Biafra land? Let me see if I have a caller on Skype. Caller on WhatsApp. Can you hear me? Do I still have a caller on WhatsApp? No, it appears I have lost that caller. We are approaching to the end of this morning program. Of course, it is just a shorter one today, but we will be back again on Wednesday, because of course tomorrow will be Radio Biafra Middle East, of course, where Biafra is rising. And then we will be back again on Wednesday from Middle East to the people of the East. My goodness me, I knew 01 hashtag we are everywhere. All right, we must continue. Of course, you know, when I talk about that woman who vomited whatever she vomited, no doubt, no argument, what she said was terrible. What she said was very, very bad. Very, very bad. But like I said, I like turning around things. You know, when my enemy tells me nonsense, in as much as I'm angry and upset with what my enemy told me, at the same time, I want to learn from what my enemy told me. Because sometimes Chukwu Kikabiam, I want to teach you a lesson with your enemies. We know about the Israelites. You know, sometimes God would let them fall into the hands of their enemy, and they will be taught a lesson, and they will learn. Because you cannot fall into the hands of your friend. You will fall into your, if you fall into the hands of your friend, there will be mercy. But when you fall into the hands of your enemy, there is no mercy. So God allows you to fall into the hands of your enemy and allow them to tell you the truth, because when you know get call God, you will appreciate, you will understand. But when your friend tell you something, sometimes you don't even believe it. You say, well, he's just trying to make me feel bad. But your enemy will tell you the truth, because your enemy knows everything about you, even what you don't know. Caller on WhatsApp, can you hear me? Caller on WhatsApp, people of the East. All right, it looks like caller on WhatsApp is not hearing me. Caller on WhatsApp, for the last time, can you hear me? I know you are there, Mazi. Can you hear me? Unbelievable. All right, we need to terminate that call, because it's either he's having a network issues or he is not following. We must continue, and we are approaching. And I'm asking, come on, I need some answers here, please. When was the first shot fired in Nigerian Biafran Civil War? What date? What month? What town? What local government? And of course, what province in Biafra land? If you know the answer, please call me, because there is what mouth-watering prizes to be won. My goodness me. If you get it right, I will not hesitate to send your prize to you, and you will get your prize, and you will say goodbye to data problem. You will be able to listen to Radio Biafra. You will be able, of course, to go online and propagate the gospel according to the restoration of Biafra. And of course, we must continue, because it is Radio Biafra. Middle East. There's so many Radio Biafras on my head, but of course, we are one people. All right, let's see who we have. Caller on WhatsApp, are you there? Can you hear me? Caller on WhatsApp, what is happening? Do I have a caller? Yes, I can hear you, Mazi. Please go ahead.
Oh, Mazi Mashineke.
There you go.
Good morning from here.
Good morning.
I'm not calling to answer the question you just
no problem.
You just put on there.
Go ahead.
I'm only calling to appreciate you for coming back again, because I really miss you. I remember Mashineke from Germany. I miss you a lot. I miss your voice. That's why I'm calling.
I miss you too.
Welcome
I miss
back.
You too, my brother. You have no idea. I miss you too.
So continue with good work you're doing, sir.
Thank you very much. And you bet continue. Thank you very much, my brother. My goodness me, it feels so good when your people miss you It feels so good when you are loved. It feels so good when you are working for your people and they appreciate you. There is no better love than that. There is no better appreciation. It is more important than silver and gold. And of course, I really appreciate working for Pierre France because this is what I do for my people and it gives me joy when I do so. It is to Radio Biafra Sadek. We are the people of the East. And of course, Johannesburg is where we are. And this is where we are coming to you live and direct. We are reaching humanity across the four corners of Earth. If you are listening to me this morning and you believe you are, how can you be so mean? If you have enough, help your brother. Come on, people. Nobody have ever made it on their own. All the stories about I'm a self-made millionaire, I did it by myself, that is pure lie. You cannot make a forest as a tree. You need trees, I mean trees with S, to make a forest. If you have made it, if you have arrived, help your brother. Sometimes you don't just need to arrive, you know. If you know something that your brother doesn't know, something that you think will help your brother to get something, just show him the way. Somebody called me, and I'm going to say this, you know, it's a mother in this struggle. She called me and said to me, "Maziki Chukwonoa, I don't want to give you money, but I want to teach you how to make fish." I'm being real. She said to me, "Maziki Chukwonoa, I don't want to give you money. Because I know maybe if I give it, you will not take it. But I want to teach you how to make fish." That's what she told me. This is a very elderly woman. And she taught me something. She made something for me that I will cherish for the rest of my life. She said to me, "I'm going to do this on your behalf. And this thing will be making you money every week." She showed me the way. My goodness me. Now, trust me, from now till December, what I'm going to make in that investment will be more bigger, huger. Assuming she gave me $1,000 or $500, you know, I would have probably used it because the problem doesn't finish. But what she taught me is something of a lifetime. This is what we should be doing as IPOBians among ourselves. If you are in a business, Nagaga, tell your brother. It will not make you less a man. It will not liquidate you. It will not limit you. This money has been here when our fathers were here. They have made their millions. Today they are dead, they are gone, and the money is still here. You will make your own, I will make my own, and life goes on. There is no need of saying on Urubewa Nambaloso just by mouth, but in your heart, you are not willing to help your brother. You don't even need to give your brother money. Just show them the way. There are things you can teach them, especially those in diaspora. You know, you can keep on sending money home if you're in diaspora. You can send it from today till eternity. They will keep on asking you. Because remember, $100, $200, $50, unlike Izunu, it's not enough. But when you teach that person what to do, or start up a business for them, or open a shop for them, or just show them some investment kind of a thing, things that you have learned in diaspora, trust me, that person will cherish it forever. They will even tell their children, "Listen, you see that man, he is a good man. He did this and that for me." Who knows? The children of that person you help might become a multi-millionaire tomorrow. When your own children are suffering, those children will say, "Wait a minute, our father told us about this man and these are his children. Let us reward them for what their father has done for our own father." That is how life goes, round and around and round and round. The world is like a football. It turns around. The world is like a wind. It blows in the west today. Tomorrow it blows in the north, south, west. If you are in the north, today the wind is blowing for you. Tomorrow it spins around. It turns to the west. What you gonna do if you're in the north and you never help the person in the east? Now that the wind is blowing for them, do you think they will remember you? That is just how the world goes. All right, we must continue. My name once again is Mazi Ikechukwu Onoha. Of course, we are rounding up, but I think I need to take one or two calls and then we will bring this program to an end. Caller on WhatsApp, are you still there? If you are there, good morning.
I'm still with you. I'm still very much.
Thank you for waiting, Mazi. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good morning.
They were watching again.
Emmanuel from Oka province in Poland.
Thank you very much. Please go ahead.
I want to really appreciate you for your wonderful
there we
with your friends. And I think with your thoughts, it's a very wise thought. That's a also I disclose material or a better would be with empowerment, the real Afra will be long, I mean will come a long way.
Thank you very much, Mazi. Go ahead. There we
that. Yes, your question, I want to, I think the question in July 1971, yes.
All right.
The Ngari came in Gakem. A town called Gakem in the upper land. I don't know what I'm around.
Mazi, you did not give me the month. You gave me the month, but you did not give me the date of the month. Did you give me the date of the month?
29th of July. 29th of July. 29th of July or thereabout.
All right, Mazi, you did not get all of them right. You just get only one thing right. And of course, in that question, we have about 5 answers. You get 1 out of 4. Thank you for trying, though.
I said in Gakem.
I heard you.
It's on in Gakem.
Yes, I heard you. Remember, I was asking the dates and the month, the town, the local government, and also the province.
I believe it's Gakem. Then the month is July. I'm not sure of the date.
All right. So you got 2 out of 5. Thank you very much for trying.
All right, sir.
All right, thank you very much. And of course, we must continue. Our brother got 2 out of 5. People might think that HMAZIKH will be a baller ganko. And go and give you 5 fans as Tigan of a question. I'm sorry, but you know, this is not the zoo education. This is Biafra education. It is hardcore. It is, you know, quality education. And the cutoff mark is not even 100 like you have in the zoo. The cutoff mark is about 500. So please bear with me. It is Biafra education. All right, let's take this call on WhatsApp. And then finally, I will go to Skype. It will be the last for today. Mazi Rafson Dikum. What can I best know na Chibu Mado? No, please go ahead. Thank you very much. I've been to Russia, but I was not inside the town. I was just only in the airport. So I have to wait for my flight for 1 week. That was in 1997. Now, Mazi, I was wearing a suit. Now, I slept in the airport wearing my suit on. And I was shaking. I did not take a bath for 1 week. I'm talking about inside the airport. I don't want to be there. Go ahead, please.
Yes, Mazi. Indeed, anytime we enter winter, I used to feel bad.
When
I remember Biafra land, where you have. You know, we don't know what we have in Biafra land. It's only British know the value of what we have. You see that you can have green leaf in your garden. That is all the year round. You can wear slippers. You can wear shorts to walk around. That is all the year round. That is the dream of Europeans. That is the dream of Europeans to have the type of nature we have.
Yes. Not to interrupt you, my son once asked me a question because I gave him a nyololo and there was ofe, you know, soup and we call it paf here, nyololo and ofe. So he asked me a question. He said to me, Daddy, between this nyololo, pap, and the soup, which one is more important? So you know what I said to him? I said to him, okay, fine. The pap is just starch. That is new lula whole starch. Then the other one I will offer. My goodness me. How pony noya? Ose noya? Egusi noya? Azu noya? All the vitamins from A to Z, you can think of it inside that soup. My goodness me. Organic food, everything is inside that soup. As a matter of fact, that is why in the village, when you finish your food and there is soup left, your parents will beat you until you drink the soup. Please go ahead. Because they understand. Thank you very much.
Yeah, that's the thing. You know, many people, Europeans and foreigners, don't know the secret of our strength. They don't know upon all the disease that is in that part of the world, upon contaminated water we are drinking and everything. And yet, you see our men and women very in that is where energy comes from. They don't know. They don't know the secret because of the natural food we are eating, and that is what we are missing abroad. And that's why I dedicate all my life to even if my last card, to make sure that Biafra come, because Mazi Kechku and Biafra are not happy, especially in winter, to be here. As I'm talking to you here now, I'm wearing almost five clothes.
I know the story, Mazi.
That is for me to listen, understand. So it's not easy. So I don't want to take much of our time, but I'm happy that the journey has started. The journey has started. And not only that the journey has started, that God at last have had a cry and give us a leader that have a vision, a leader that have direction, a leader that know where he's going, a leader that nothing that he cannot distract. You see, we are on this sleeping DJ recently. They're crying because our leader don't give them attention. Don't talk on what that is, because that's what they want. They want distraction. So we are happy that Kichuko Kita have given us a leader that have destination, that have direction, that have vision, that wins or even stone, nothing can be able to divert his attention. He know where he's going. Our target is Biafra, and that's where he's going.
Thank you very much.
We should be happy that in our own generation that God gave us such a leader, and it's our duty to make sure that we support and obey the last order. Anything that he tells us to do, we have to do it without even asking person, because he know where he's going. I had recently what happened in Olo. After the police department said that that is the story of Eastern Security Network is a propaganda. And last week, I believe they really known that they have witnessed that is the test of iceberg. They have known now that it's no more a propaganda, but that it is real. And that also make them to know that Biafra have come to stay. So it is all our duty, every Biafran's place, for us to support this our security network, because they are there. That is the beginning. People who say that when our leader say that Biafra last year, if we work hard, and that Biafra came last year, but people that are blind don't know that Biafra have come. People that are blind don't know that Biafra had come. That word of our leader was a prophetic word, and he fulfilled it on December. That is the day he announced our security network outfit. That is the day that Biafra, that prophecy come to fulfillment. But the people that are canal, the people that are the saboteurs, they cannot understand it. Understand? So, but we that are following him, we that
right.
Also know that can be able to lead the hand right on the world, we know that Biafra come. And it's our duty to make sure that as Biafra come, we have to defend it with our last blow.
Thank you very much, Master.
I want to thank you for giving this opportunity, and also all the IPB family here in Russia Federation, that God will bless all of us.
Bless
and also
you too.
Give us the grace to continue and to play our own role to make sure that our dream is come to materialization. Thank you, man, for
Master Dickon. All right. Thank you very much, Mazi Rafson Ndikum. Of course, I understand it is not easy to be in the diaspora, especially a place like Russia. Like I said, I've been to Russia, but, you know, I was not inside. I was in transit. I was only in the airport for 1 week. Can you imagine somebody who is in the airport wearing his suit? You didn't take it off. You are wearing suit to sleep and wake up, and you didn't take a bath for 1 week. Not because there is no place to take a bath, but because we are too mad. You know, Oige asum Oige Megini Adobu Mara Adobu. So you can understand what our people go through and why they want Biafra so quick. My goodness me, our time is exhausted. I have a caller on Skype that I'm going to go to right now. And of course, our competition will still continue on Wednesday. Then if you know the answer, you can give it to us. We'll try as much as we can, to make it easier going forward, because I see that I'm giving our people overdose with those questions. And of course, if you want to sponsor the competition, please inbox me, Mike Biafra Obi. Mike Biafra Obi on Facebook. You inbox me, Mike Biafra Obi. We are trying to see if we can use this competition to help our people back home in Biafra in terms of recharge voucher, which they can use to buy data to listen to Radio Biafra, as well as, Facebook, and also, to do the work which they are supposed to do. So inbox me on Mike Biafra Obi. We'll tell you what to do and how it will happen. And we thank our brother Mazi Simon Ayanugo, who have sponsored us in this ongoing one, of course, which will end in a couple of weeks, maybe a week or two, and then we will continue again and see if we have another sponsor or not. But we would like to go on till February, because January and February is history month on people of the East. All right, I think let me take this call. My brother on Skype, please don't be upset, we will come to you. Caller on WhatsApp, are you still there? Caller on WhatsApp.
Good morning, I'm still here.
Thank you very much. You are the last caller on WhatsApp today. Please go ahead.
My name is Chanyuwa Mike. I'm from Abosi.
There we
go. Okay, the answer to your question is it's happening at Zopa, Enugu State, 6th July 1967.
All right, Mazi. Are you done with your answer?
Yes.
All right, you actually got one thing right and you got one or the other one wrong. So sorry about that, Mazi. You did not get it right. Thank you very much. All right.
Okay.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you very much for trying. Let me go to Skype and we will wrap it up. Caller on Skype. All right. Let me switch off something, Mazi, on Skype. Just 1 second for me. There we go. Caller on Skype. Please go ahead.
Yeah, Mazi, a very, very, very good morning to you.
Thank you very much.
Yes, saying that I miss you is an understatement, but I think we have no better words than to say I miss you, South Africa miss you,
my goodness,
and
me
to have you back.
Thank you very much, Maz. I miss you too, even though we're in the same country.
Yes, yeah.
Please go ahead.
It's like when you're in Lagos and you're staying in Surrey, family stays in Bariga.
I get that.
Stay in Lagos for 5 years without even seeing each other, but it's well,
thank
my
you,
brother.
Thank you very much, Mazi. Please go ahead.
Happy New Year to you, Mazi. I want to say something. I don't want to answer the question anyway. I want to say I hear what Okeford said and Labai. We are all away when these questions was this. But now I want to talk something about and to BRICS. I think all so-called Delta, Niger Delta should wake up, because when Antobris was talking, I was carefully listening to her. She brought the issue of so-called Niger Delta and she said old eastern region, and then I think she's trying to let their people know about this so-called Niger Delta does not mean make any sense, and I love her enthusiasm and her strength together with our mother and our auntie Onyeka Onwelu. I want to agree with you 100%. I also agree with her, Rabbi Chais, because the woman that's supposed to get award for telling our people go home from so-called middle belt, I think I agree with you 100%. I will add to the award you want to give to her. My name is again is Mazi Chukwudi. I'm calling from Port Elizabeth here in South Africa. Tunachineke, yes, this is our home. I'm ready.
Mazi Chukwudi, have we met in person before? Have we met in person?
It's like we have met in person because we always talk. So our friendship has become as if we have met in person.
Because I remember, you know, when I was in East London, and I was supposed to go to Port Elizabeth. I actually came there to broadcast in East London. That was in 2018 maybe, or 2017. I'm not sure.
Yeah,
I was supposed to come to Port Elizabeth, but I didn't make it at the end of the day. Yes.
Yeah.
But it is well. I will come there. That I can assure you. I will come there.
Don't worry.
Thank you very much.
So I love the lady that have given us a very good push. If our people could understand that what Zoom means for everyone. Go home. Go home. We don't need you. If she have a rethink before she came to the program, or her manifesto of coming to the program is to tell our people go home. You know, after listening to our brother Yekengwelu of anybody that looks for his goat, he says a Biafran. So why don't you go home? You know, I 100% agree with you. But there is one flavor that was on that program, and our people didn't quietly pick up what that guy said. That guy, after giving him a chance, he just have 1 second. I think he spoke for about 1-2 seconds. He's asking the West, are you going to support us?
I heard him well, sir. And there's another thing that woman said. She said, why are you people asking telling the world not that you want to leave? Yeah, are we your masters? I will keep on taunting us with that. She said, why are you people, why do you see it necessary and fit to report to us that you want to leave Nigeria? If you want to leave, leave. That is $1 million word. That is $1 million word. And like our leader always said, our leader have never said to the North, allow us to go. No. Our leader is telling them, we are leaving. And it's not actually telling the North. He's telling the zoo. Everybody in the zoo. Because when you say you are telling the North, it's like you're giving them preferential treatment. You understand? So you just have to say it the way it is. Even Paayo Adebanjo said to them, the North is not special. What does the North think? That they're the ones who will decide whether they will restructure or whether there will be a referendum or not. I mean, who the hell are the North? They are just one human being with one head. So I don't think there is anything special about them. Thank you, my brother. Thank you. We'll leave it there. Thank you very much for calling. We appreciate your call.
Thank you so much, my brother.
Thank you. All right. Of course, this is where we are going to leave it. And we will be back again on Wednesday, because like I said, Tuesday, we go to Middle East. Of course, it is people. I mean, what do we call it? Biafra Rising. That's right. Biafra Rising. And of course, on Wednesday, we are back again to the people of the East. We are everything revolves. We are everything always starts because the sun rises from the East, and we are the people of the East. All right, don't forget, of course, we are going to have a fasting and prayer on the 30th of January. That is this month, 30th of January, to which is Monday. All right, let me start again. On Saturday, 30th of January to Monday, 1st of February 2021, there will be IPOB Biafrans Worldwide Fasting and Prayer. And of course, the theme for this fasting is commanding this year, 2021, to favor Biafrans. All right, we are going to post, of course, the information with regards to this fasting on Facebook. And I'm sure you have seen it flying around on your WhatsApp group. Please grab it and see the details, of course, as well as the prayer point and the Bible passage that you need. Of course, don't forget that this was prepared by Evangelist Ozak Nwokike, Pastor Frederick Nwohia, Pastor Chris Wise, and it was signed by Mazi Oscar Okeke, head of IPOB Religious Affairs. All right, Before I close, I really appreciate our mothers because honestly, in this work that we are doing, in this struggle, our mothers are doing a special work that you don't even know. When we are down, remember we are human beings, now and then you need some encouragement, and our mothers are doing just that. And I will want to appreciate our mother, Josephine Erewa, you know, who is in the United States of America. She has been a mother indeed. I want to appreciate our mother, Rachel Wosu in Israel. She has been a mother indeed to me. I don't know about you. And also, I want to appreciate also, there is a woman here in South Africa. She is actually our account person, and she is Mrs. Gloria. I keep forgetting her surname, but it is Mrs. Gloria. She is in Cape Town, if I'm not mistaken. These are the people, and when I say they are doing great and marvelous things, it's not all about cash or money. Words of encouragement is very powerful. Words of encouragement, motherly advice, you know, it goes a long way and it does magic. I just want to say to them that I appreciate them. And of course, in closing, like I said, we are going to roll over this competition to Wednesday, just to be fair to our people. Maybe on Wednesday, we'll see what we will do. If we don't get a winner, then of course, we will tell you what is the answer. Then going forward, we might try to make it a little bit easier because I've seen that the people are struggling with this one. But we are going to make sure that we make it the way it will be easy for you. But you know, this is Biafra education. There is no easy way. This is not zoo education. Get past here. Even an email again. A pastory. That is how we do it, and this is how it's gonna be in Biafra. All right, in closing, I want to thank you Biafrans all around the world for your effort and your support, and of course making this program a worthwhile this morning. I say may Ezio Kike bless you all, and may God bless our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. May God bless Biafrans all around the world. I want to close in with this. There is a song that I'm going to play now, but there is a story behind this song. This is Urobo traditional composer. His name is Omoko Moko, who was born blind, but became a famous Urobo traditional song composer and producer using locally made instruments. Though he is a blind man, but he could sense that things are life is no longer the same in the zoo and contraption called Nigeria. NEPA is making life a mystery to Nigerians. Instead of electricity, people are spending money to purchase candles and of course generator, I add, which in most situations cause fire, hazards, and destruction of lives and properties. Though Omoko died over 30 years ago, but his songs are still very famous in Urobo. Hope you will try to listen to this wonderful ancient Urobo traditional music by late Chief Omoko Moko. No doubt wherever he is now, he would say to those who want the Nigeria, how far now? How is life now? All right, thank you very much, great beer friends, and of course I appreciate you all, and this is where we are going to leave it. And I say may God bless you all, and I will see you soon again on Wednesday. God bless Biafra.